Welcome to this week's Monday Minutes. My name is Kelly.
And my name is Jesse, and we are coming to you live from ACRL in the beautiful city of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. We've gotten to see so many of our partners out here this week and potential libraries that are thinking about making the switch to open source, and we're very excited.
This is super fun. It's been fun.
It's been fun. But today what we're going to talk to you about is a new feature that you will see in the upcoming release for item templates. So now you can apply saved fields to those items when you're creating them.
This is a great, so think of all your juvenile special things, you're assigning a collection code, a shopping location. This can all be saved by an item template. So let's walk through this, Jesse.
Okay,
so we should probably just start off and look at a record. Okay, so if we click on to the title, and then we decide that we want to add another item. So I'm just going to go up here and create a new item. I now have this area at the top that allows me to use an existing template that I've already created. I can also have two different types of templates, shared templates, so something that we're using within the system, or my own template. So you do have those options. You can see that once I pick a template from this dropdown, I can hit apply. And what happens? All that information is filled out for me. So I'm getting the main floor stacks has been populated for me. So let's go through and create. I can also clear and delete a template. These are permissions. So we're going to pull up somebody with the permissions specific to this. If you're creating a template from scratch for the first time, you would go ahead and fill out information. So say, you know, maybe I wanted to start doing a staff collection. Who knows? I can create this information, whatever I want to put here, maybe staff only. Then I have this option down here at the bottom, then I can save this template. And this is me creating a new template. And then here would allow me to either share or not share. I'm a sharer in the world.
Let's
share. I'm going to go ahead and hit save and share. Now, when I come up here, I have this template and it's considered mine because I'm logged in and I'm using my own. If I click that, apply that template,
I now
can see all the choices that I already did, which is fantastic. Fantastic. So we wanted to just give you an example of how to use those.
Kelly, why don't we look at the permissions now that you can assign for your staff members?
Absolutely. So I'm just going to pop in. So here we go. We're just going to show it to you. And here we have a new permission under cataloging, edit catalog, create, update, and delete item editor templates owned by others. So that is a permission that your staff would need to be able to create, update, so alter or delete. This is really fantastic, and I'm really excited.
Oh yeah,
to show this, and you know, 2211 is chock-a-block full of things.
Oh my
gosh,
we're
just beginning to show you what there is here.
Yeah, we can't wait.
We can't wait. There is ice cream, so we're gonna head out and get some ice cream. But have a great week.
Bye.
Bye.